is Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my growing extended beautiful family, just thank you so much for the love and support. Just being there and just letting me be in your life as you be in mine is really truly a blessing. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell at the bottom so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. Also, if you are comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I'd love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you just help tell me about your empathic gift and how it impacted your life and heading you towards positive direction. If you feel like the video is being very informative to you or gives you good vibes, love to share with a loved one, family, or friend, please go ahead and do so. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And thank you once again for love and support. It's so greatly appreciated, and I'm glad you're able to resonate with me, and I hope you're able to resonate and relate to the video. And today I'm listening to Heal and Balance Your Emotions, Positive Energy, Slow Meditation, Inner Peace, Healing Music. And I'll post that link in the description box below. And today my video is about when ascension tests your faith and your patience. Oh my gosh, y'all. Today has been really crazy for me. I had to go get my tags in the state of Georgia. You know, you're usually supposed to get your tags around your birthday, but you know, things happen or whatever, and so I had to get them late. So it was like the last of the month, and it was crazy up at the DMV, and I'm just like, I had to be there for 3 hours. Well, a whole bunch of annoyed people. You talking about I had to put all the armor of God on me. I'm like, Lord, please don't let me have to snap on nobody. There was one woman getting into it with the cops. I'm just like, Lord, bless her, bless her, bless her. But it's just like with this ascension coming, they said it starts between the 6th and the 19th. But it's just the fact is that message in hyper kick drive for me early, like two weeks early, because I was going through it last week. Because it's like all the stuff that I was telling you that it just said for twin flames, but there was a lot of things that was going on for the Heyoka as well too, you know, from the messages I'm getting from other people, what situations they're going through. And I know it can be annoying, and you know, going through these situations with the spring equinox, the Mercury retrograde, the crescent moon, the snow moon, and all these other different stuff that's going around. And it's just the fact is we're, you know, all of our energy is like combined, and it's just like manifesting and manifesting and manifesting to the point where we're folding dimensions, portal jumping, as well as sitting up here making a multiverse and an omniverse at the same time. What the hell, God? I'm like, what is going on? But it's just so, it's like surreal to me. Being able to get all these different messages from the universe, and it's just being able to speak these things to you. And it's, you know, it sounds crazy to me, but then it's like, okay, then it makes a lot of sense. You know, all of us is like, we feel like we're going through a lot of hell at one time. We feel like at times the universe is punishing us. But no, we have to keep thinking about it. We're holding stuff back from our past lives. They're saying that we're going to be that generation that breaks those curses and the cycles. So you expect us to go through all this. But it's just like they know, they trained us as super soldiers before we came out to this one anyway. Because they already let us know this is going to be that one. This is going to be that life that's going to test your faith as well as your patience. You know, you got beautiful things that's coming towards your life. You're getting all the signs to let you know, hey, they're coming, but you have to be able to be patient. Believe in yourself, believe in the universe, that all these different beautiful things you're manifesting, you're getting the signs here, you're getting the signs there. And it's just like going through all this really drives your patience. Because I'm just steady. It's like I'm up in the line waiting to get my little sticker for my car, just scratching like crazy because I feel all the energy that was coming through that line because people got tired of standing there. I was in there from 11:30 all the way until almost 3 o'clock. That was too daggone long to be around annoying people. And they were very annoying. And they weren't annoying me, but it's just all their energy. I'm like, oh my God, if I don't hurry up and get up out of here, y'all taking too long. Y'all acting like y'all had to make the sticker yourself. You know, and it was just like going through all these different things. And I know that all my love bugs, they're going through one thing or another. You're trying to clear your karma. You're trying to make sure that you're thinking positive and not watching what you, being mindful of what you put out towards people. Not judging, you know, let go of your painful, you know, your painful past or anything that you have really been going through that caused you trauma during your life. And I know that is really hard because it's just like when I keep telling myself when I'm going through this, you know, and the God and universe like, Roslynn, you better stop talking about that stuff. It makes you sound like you're cocky. And I'm like, Lord, that's not really what I'm doing. Because, you know, with my situation with me, you know, just cutting them cords, like I straight cut them cords, you know, with my abusers. They did all the things to me. But it was just like, if I'm that type of person, I don't beat around the bush about anything. And people used to laugh at me for being that way because it's just like, you know, somebody could come up to me, it's like, Roslynn, you really don't like me, do you? I'm like, no, I don't. And, you know, I'm just like, I'm not even going to beat around the bush like that. But I try to be mindful of stuff, you know, of not being so mean to people. But it's just like, why would I lie, though? If I don't like you, I just don't like you. You know, and it's just, you know, I didn't mean to be that way. You know, I didn't really mean to be that way. But it was just like, you know, when my adopted father asked me to come, you know, to a barbecue, and I was like, dude, I was just tolerating you for that moment. That last time you see me was the last time I was going to see you, and that was on purpose. Next time I see you, it might be on an accident. So, you know, I wasn't trying to be that way, but shoot, I ain't going to lie to you. It's between me and you, I'm going to be that one that tells the truth. Now, I always say the black sheep of the family is always the one that tells the truth about certain things. It's just being just more straightforward about it. But it's just like when you're going through these situations, know that your faith and your patience are going to be constantly tested. Certain situations are going to come into your life just to see how you're going to respond to them. So be careful. Be careful. Going through all these different things, it's just a beautiful thing where it's like people are reaching out to me and asking me, Roslynn, what do you feel like is going in my life? I feel like I'm about to lose my mind and this and that. Can you feel my energy? And half of the time, I'm like, yes, can you, like, turn down the volume to your energy, please? Because I'm like, calm down. I'm here. I'm going to help. You know, I'm going to do the best thing I can. And that is the most beautiful blessing that God has placed on me. Even though I might go through hell and back with the situations that I constantly deal with. But that's fine. You know, I had to go through my situation because this is my divine purpose, to be able to go through some really serious trauma and be able to use that as a billboard to help other empaths along their way that's doing things. And it's not like I feel like I'm better than anybody else, but I feel like I'm blessed. I really do. I really feel like I'm blessed because it's like when y'all talk to me, I constantly, you know, I tell you how it is, but I congratulate you at the same time. Because a lot of times we really go through stuff, and just for the fact is what we have endured in life, you know, we always have something negative come to us talking about you're never going to make it, you know, being who you are, or you're not going to amount to anything when you grow up. Nobody don't know that. You could be a homeless person. I mean, I've seen about three links in the last couple of weeks about some homeless kids that's getting scholarships, that's going to Harvard, that's going to Yale. I said, now see, them kids was living out on the street begging for something. Now they're going to these top Ivy League schools. Nobody don't know where you're going. God knows. Universe knows. You might have them signs that you know, because sometimes we'll be so at the rock bottom of that bottom. And it might feel like you are not coming out. But it's just like, soon as universe get a hold of you and snatch you up, it's gonna scare the ancestors to death. I promise you. I promise you. Because it's like, there's times like today, you know, I was like very sensitive today. Very sensitive. I was in that line about to start crying. I'm like, girl, don't you do that. I was like, don't you do that. I don't know where it was coming from. I'm like, pop it up. Don't be a punk. Don't be a punk. And I'm just sitting there, and I don't know where the heck that crying came from. But it was like, I was, you know, I was just reading my little things from, you know, my little positive you know, group form off of Facebook, and they were really speaking some words, and it was just like, you know, like I told y'all, there are certain things that, you know, I'll see a post that'll pop up, and I'm like, hey, I can make a video about that, or, you know, I see it, and it was really speaking volumes to me, and it's just like, when I ask universe, hey, can you let me know what you want me to speak on today, let my family know the things that they need to do, for the words of encouragement, because a lot of times, we need that. You know, that friendly reminder saying, hey, you're going to be okay. Hey, just be patient just a little bit longer. You're going to get it. You might not be where you want to be, but this is not the end for you. If it's not okay, it's not the end. You know, and I seen a post about that, and that's going to be another video. But it's just, it's true. Just because your situation is not okay right now, don't think this because your current situation is your final destination, because it's not. It's not. Because it's like, this going to be a situation that's going to just catapult you into the next blessing that you're not even prepared for yet. That's the reason why it ain't ready yet, because God's still fixing up some stuff for you. And you need to be ready for when it comes. That's why I'm just like, you know, I'm just in it, you know, I'm in it for to win it, basically. Doing my part. Yeah, times get hard as hell. I believe that. Trust me, I know. You know, times get hard as heck. You be ready to slap the mess out of something. I don't know what it is, but you need to slap the mess out of something because you're tired of dealing with stuff. Yes, we are all emotionally, mentally, spiritually tired. But at the end of the day, when all this is said and done, you're going to be glad for them sweat. You're going to be glad for those tears. You're going to be glad for that blood that was drawn, because you already know everything you have ever did on this earth at this time on this life is not going to be in vain. It's not. It really isn't. So you're going through all these different things. Know that better days are coming for you. Know that all the things that have been brought down to you is not going to break you. You might have bent up a little bit, but it ain't going to break you. You know, I used to use that word broken, but I'm not like, you know what, ain't no daggone plate. And neither are you. You're not a plate. You might get bent up and out of shape and wore the heck out, but that's all right, though. I'm going to whip you right back in the shape. And it's just like, when you enter that fire, you're going to step out and you're going to be smelling like smoke. Hello. You are not. So be patient with yourself. Keep doing you. Keep grinding. Keep shining. Don't give up. If there's some naysayers in your path trying to tell you what you can't do, they don't know. Because just because you're not making that effort to do what you have to do for your dreams don't mean I'm about to give up on mine. That's all on you. That is all on you. So don't let the naysayers and that darkness come creep up on you, because they will try to catch you slipping. So I hope you were able to resonate with the content of this video. I hope y'all have a blessed weekend. Do everything you need to do. Send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. Know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, and forever loved. And knowing there's always someone out there praying for your better days. And the post notification shout out goes to Robert Cole. Buddy Pree, much love to you, and thank you for that comment. And Jay Cotwright, much love to you as well. And I will see you on my next video. Send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. And know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, forever loved. And knowing there's always someone out there praying for your better days. Give me a thumbs up, like, and also share. Drop me a line and let me know. Are you feeling this? Are you resonating with this? But every day is going to be okay. Every day is going to be okay. You're going to have to find some blessing within that day. So I will see you on my next video. Much love, peace, and be wild.